In a previous screencast, we showed how to find an overall heat transfer coefficient using conductive and convective resistances. Here we'll use this method to calculate a contact resistance in a composite wall. So here we have a wall. It has a height of 4 meters and a thickness. We go back into the page. Our thickness is 10 centimeters. Out here, we have the temperature of the air, which is 50 degrees C. And coming out here, we have a temperature of the bulk fluid equal to 125 degrees C. The following information is given. We have our convective heat transfer coefficients, and we have the lengths of the wall with their thermal conductivity. However, there is a contact resistance between material 1 and 2, so right here, and we want to know what is the maximum that contact resistance can be in order to have a heat transfer rate of 50 watts. Our governing equation is that our heat transfer rate is equal to this overall heat transfer coefficient times the area that the heat transfer goes through times the change in temperature. So how do we find the contact resistance? It's part of the calculation for you, because this overall heat transfer coefficient is equal to the sum of all the thermal resistances raised to the minus 1. So we can calculate this U. We can rewrite U as the heat transfer rate divided by the area times delta T. And when we calculate that U, we find out that it is equal to 1.67 watts per meter squared Kelvin. But U also equals the inverse of the sum of the resistances. So 1 over U, which equals 0.6 meters squared Kelvin per watt, is going to equal the sum of these resistances. So what do these resistances, what is the sum equal to? So this 0.6 is going to be equal to 1 over H1 plus L1 over K1. The first one is convective, followed by the first conductive resistance, the second conductive resistance, and the third conductive resistance. So these are through the different materials of the wall, plus our convective resistance on the other side of the wall, plus this thermal contact resistance that we're looking for. So when we solve for that, it's going to equal 0.118 meters squared Kelvin per watt. Note that we would get the same number even if the resistance were between material 2 and material 3.